Good morning, students. In the last lecture, we discussed seventh lesson from the book First Flight, that is Glimpses of India, and we studied first part of it, that is A Baker from Goa. Today we will study second part, that is Coorg. This lesson is written by Lokesh Abrol. Lokesh Abrol is a doctor and a social activist. He is also a writer, and he has written this lesson, Coorg. This lesson is about this beautiful place. So, this lesson also highlights his sharp observations and the ability for graphic description of this wonderful land that is called Coorg. So now, as this lesson starts, the first line it is given that Coorg is a coffee country which is famous for its rainforest and spices. You must be wondering whether Coorg is a state, district or a country, because the writer has written it as a country. But actually it is not a country, it is the smallest district in Karnataka state. And it is famous for its rainforest and coffee, and for beautiful landscape also. So we will study in detail its culture and its landscape, about its beauty and what are the things that are found there, why it is so special. So, as the lesson starts, midway between Mysore and the coastal town of Mangalore sits a piece of heaven that must have drifted from the kingdom of God. Now, the writer starts the story and he says that this place stands between Mysore and Mangalore, and this is the smallest district of Karnataka, and it seems like a piece of heaven that has come down from the heaven with air. It is so beautiful that the writer calls it heaven. The land of rolling hills is inhabited by a proud race of martial men, beautiful women and wild creatures. And what he says that this place of high hills is occupied, it is inhabited by people who live there, they are martial men. Martial men means soldiers. Okay, and beautiful women, and it is a place of wild creatures also. Coorg or Kodagu, the smallest district of Karnataka, is home to evergreen rainforests, spices and coffee plantations. As I already told you, this place is also called Kodagu. Now, this place is famous for evergreen rainforests, spices and coffee plantations. Evergreen forests cover 30% of this district. Now you can easily tell that rainforests that cover around 30% of this place. During the monsoons, it pours enough to keep many visitors away. As you know that in equatorial region, the rainforest, they bring heavy rain, rainforests are there and they bring heavy rain. So monsoon season, it pours so heavily that it keeps away the visitors, because visitors are not allowed at that time. The season of joy commences from September and continues till March. From September to March, it is a time for the visitors. Anyone can visit there. It's the weather is perfect with some showers thrown in for good measure. And it is a place where now in September onward, there is light rain only, and which cools the weather and keep it comfortable for the visitors. The air breathes of invigorating coffee. Now, as we can see, what is written by the writer, that the air breathes of invigorating coffee. Invigorating means the coffee plantation is so much there that even in the air you can feel the fragrance of coffee all the time. Coffee estates and colonial bungalows stands tucked under tree canopies in prime corners. Coffee estate, there are coffee plantation is much there, and colonial bungalow, colonial means olden times bungalows, stand tucked under tree canopies. And trees, there are so many trees around that they make they make the shape of a canopy. Canopy, you understand, roof like covering that form shelters. So these bungalows are covered with trees all around, okay, and they are found in the prime corners. The fiercely independent people of Kurg are possibly of Greek or Arabic descent. Now the writer is talking about that the people of this place, they are descendant of either Greek or Arabic people. Because as one story goes, a part of the Alexander's army moved south along the coast and settled here when return became impractical. Now he says that Alexander's army settled there because their return was not possible, so they settled there, and that's why this place is now having the culture of that these people. Now what it says that these people married amongst the locals, and their culture is apparent in the martial traditions, marriages and religious rites, which are distinct from the Hindu mainstream. And what it says that these soldiers, they married among themselves there, they settled there, and after that their culture is apparent, that is very clearly visible in the marriages or traditions, religious rites, and which are totally different from Hindu people. The theory of Arab origin draws support from the long black coat. Now the theory of Arabic origin, that is supported by their dress also, because they wear long black coat with an embroidered waist belt worn by the Kodavas known as Kupia. So now they worn special kind of dress, black coat, which is embroidered waist belt, and they having a waist belt also which is embroidered, and this is worn by Kodavas, those people there, and known as Kupia. It resembles the Kufia worn by the Arabs and the Kurds, and this dress is similar to the dress worn by those Arabian people. That's why the theory reveals that these people, they settled there, Arabian people, they settled there, and because of that this place is affected by Arabian people, and all the culture, traditions, marriage, everything that is according to them. Okay. Kurgi homes have a tradition of hospitality, and they are more than willing to recount numerous tales of valor related to their sons and fathers. So now what he says that these Kurgi people, their homes have a tradition of hospitality. They welcome the guests, and they are more than willing to recount numerous tales of valor related to their sons and father, because they have so many stories to tell about the bravery of their sons or the fathers. Kurg regiment is one of the most decorated in the Indian army. Now you must have heard that word also, Kurg regiment. This is also a part of Indian army. General Karyappa, the Indian army, and the first chief of the Indian army, General Karyappa, was a Kurgi. So now we know that first Indian army chief was also a Kurg. Okay, he was General Karyappa. Even now, Kodavas are the only people in India permitted to carry firearms without a license. They are so believed that they can carry firearms, they can carry guns without any license, because they are warriors, they are soldiers. The river Kaveri obtains its water from the hills and forest of Kurg. So now famous Kaveri river, that also, as we know, that is in Karnataka, so that also flows from the hills and forest of Kurg. Mahasir, a large freshwater fish, abounds in these waters, and this mahasir fish is also found in this river. Kingfishers dive for their catch. Kingfisher is a bird that dive in the river for catching the fish, while squirrels and langurs drop partially eaten fruit for the mischief of enjoying the splash and ripple effect in the clear water. The water is so clear, and the langur and squirrel, they drop their partially eaten fruit in that river, and to enjoy the splash ripples formed by the splash of water. Elephants enjoy being bathed and scrubbed in the river by their mouths. And elephants, you can also see elephants there, they also are bathed by their mouths. The most laid-back individuals become converts to the life of high-energy adventures with river rafting, canoeing, rappelling, rock climbing and mountain climbing. So actually now, as I told you, it's a tourist place. So the people who want to relax, who want to enjoy, they come to this place and convert into those who want to relax, but they become high energy adventurers, because there are so many adventurous sports like rafting, okay, and canoeing, rappelling is actually going down a cliff with a rope, okay, and mountain climbing. These are also all the part of these adventure sports available there. Even mountain biking is also available. Numerous walking trails in this region are a favorite with trekkers. So छोटे छोटे बहुत सारे रास्ते बने हुए हैं एंड दे आर यूज बाय द ट्रैकर्स फॉर ट्रैकिंग ऑल्सो. बर्ड्स एंड बीज एंड बटरफ्लाइज आर देयर टू गिव यू कंपनी. नाउ बर्ड्स, बीज एंड बटरफ्लाइज, दीज आर ऑल्सो फाउंड इन एम्पल नंबर. मकाउस, मालाबार स्क्वर्ल्स, लंगूर्स एंड स्लेंडर लॉरीज कीप ए वॉचफुल आई फ्रॉम द ट्री कैनोपी. सो नाउ मकाउस, मालाबार स्क्वर्ल्स, लंगूर्स, स्लेंडर लॉरीज, दे आर ऑल द डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ क्रिएचर्स फाउंड देयर. दे आर ऑल्सो फाउंड ऑन द ट्रीज. आई डू हावेवर प्रेफर टू स्टेप असाइड फॉर वाइल्ड एलिफेंट. सो ही जस्ट सेज, द राइटर सेज दैट आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू कीप असाइड फ्रॉम द वाइल्ड एलिफेंट्स. The climb to the Brahmagiri Hills brings you into a panoramic view of the entire misty landscape of Kurg. So now, Brahmagiri Hills are there. People go trek there, go to that place, and this is a beautiful place which can give you a full view of that beautiful landscape also, which is available in Kurg. A walk across the raw bridge leads to the 64-acre island of Nishagradham. So now. Now there is a ropeway also. There you reach a place that is Nishagradham, that is 64-acre island. It is a different place. Running into Buddhist monks from India's largest Tibetan settlements at nearby Bailekuppa is bonus. So now, after that, you can also visit. Actually, the writer has also told that which places you can visit. And this is also given that this is Buddhist tapestries are also there. And running into Buddhist monks from India's largest Tibetan settlement. Tibet's people, they all settle there, Buddhist people. And that is also available at Bailekuppa is a bonus that you can go to that place also. The monks in red, orange, auraca and yellow robes are amongst the many surprises that wait to be discovered by visitors searching for the heart and soul of India right here in Kurg. So now monks there, they wear red, orange or yellow dresses, and there are so many surprises that awaits that you are, if you are in search for heart and soul of India right here in Kurg, that you can find there. That way to be discovered by visitors searching for the heart and soul of India right here in Kurg is available. So this is a beautiful place, it's a beautiful landscape, it is famous for coffee plantation, and this is all given the writer observation. He is a keen observer also, and he has described in detail about this beautiful place. So you can study and you can do the question answers followed NCERT question followed after this lesson. Thank you.